Welcome, explorers. I'm Joe Acaba, astronaut and current chief of NASA's astronaut office. But before I became an astronaut, I was a math and science teacher. Now I use my passion for teaching to teach astronauts. And here's the secret. They're just like you. They learn and discover every day. NASA is returning to the moon with our new mission called Artemis. And you are part of the Artemis generation, and we need you for this very important mission. Are you ready? In a few minutes, you will be stepping into the roles of NASA experts and learning what it takes to make lunar exploration possible with our new education content from Next Gen STEM called NASA's Exploration Experience. Like real NASA experts, we want you to be problem solvers, explore the knowns and unknowns, generate possible solutions, consider pros and cons of each solution, determine the best path forward, and finally, present your findings to your team. Remember, be creative and curious, ask questions, test and retest, and most importantly, work as a team because we are better together. I can't wait to see what you, the Artemis generation, can do. Let's go, explorers.
Hey, team members, Explorer Josh here with your mission briefing and assignment. Please have your mission information in front of you as you prepare for your assignment. The focus is on the tools astronauts are going to use on the moon. Here is your mission background.
When NASA first sent
astronauts to the moon during the Apollo era, an important part of their mission was to collect lunar rock samples.
Okay, we want to get a rake.
One of the things, of course, we're looking for is a variety of rocks here.
The tools they used were designed to be lightweight, strong, and easy to use while wearing a bulky spacesuit. Building on this knowledge today, teams at NASA have been redesigning tools for upcoming Artemis missions, which will bring humans back to the moon for the first time in decades.
I recently went to Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, to meet four experts who can help you succeed on your mission.
Heather Bergman is a project manager overseeing the team designing the next generation of lunar geology tools.
What does a project manager do at NASA?
A project manager has to wear a lot of hats. They have to understand the problem that you're trying to solve. They have to understand their team members and delegate different activities to each of those team members based on their strengths. And then they need to be able to fill in any of the gaps where their team needs them.
Holly Newton is a lunar tool engineer working on the design and functionality of the Artemis tools.
A tools engineer designs, develops, and tests tools that we're going to use on spacewalks. I could be sitting at my computer and making 3D models. I have a project manager that will define my tasks and help me move forward with my projects. I work with a systems engineer who keeps me honest about the tool requirements and making sure the features I'm designing into a tool is meeting those requirements. I work with geologists and figure out what types of samples they want to take, and from there we make tools to collect those samples. So for example, we have a scoop here, and so this helps us take a big scoop of regolith and bring it back from the moon.
Sarosh Nandwani is a human factors engineer whose role is to evaluate the usability of designs for the astronauts.
Human factors engineers do a lot of the testing work. So while a tools engineer is going to be designing a lot of these tools and making sure that they operate effectively, they're not going to break easily, a human factors engineer will come in and say, hang on, can a human actually use this? So every size astronaut, whether that's their hand size, their finger size, the amount of strength that they have, every kind of astronaut has to be able to use every kind of tool. So one example is the gloves. So there are different sizes of gloves. There is a small, a medium, a large. Every single one of those glove sizes has to be able to use every single kind of tool. And the sizes do vary a lot, so we do need to make sure that all the tools have the amount of dimensions that they need so that people can use all of them.
Rostislav Kovtun is a geologist specializing in lunar sample collection and handling.
Getting rocks or samples from the lunar surface helps us understand our planet as well as our solar system in a lot more detail.
So how do you decide what tool to use for your mission?
Yeah, so different tools serve different purposes. They allow you to retain different rock sizes.
We use several different tools for collecting, starting with the scoop.
The scoop basically retains any material, even the finest particle sizes in your scoop, and you have what we call a bulk sample.
Then the rake.
The rake has a larger mesh on the bottom of it, and when you scoop up a bunch of materials, like this, and you kind of shake it a little bit, you see a lot of the fine particles sort of fall out,
yeah,
and a lot of the larger sort of half an inch or larger rocks sort of stay in.
And finally, the tongs.
And so what the tongs sort of allow us to do is to take larger single sample, and once we have a sample, we need a sample bag to put the sample in. There you go. And all you do is just drop the sample right into the bag.
Heather, Holly, Sarosh, and Rostislav are part of a very large team working together to ensure the ease and success of future lunar sample collections. Now, it's your turn. Here is your mission assignment.
Working together, you and your teammates will need to build and test your own set of lunar tools using PVC pipe, magnets, wooden rods, cardboard, markers, tape, glue, and a few other supplies. Working under the guidance of your mission director, you will then test your tools in a simulated lunar environment to gather samples, analyze how well the tools are working, decide what needs improvement, and then redesign and retest everything. Please check in with your mission director to ensure all safety guidelines are followed throughout your mission.
To increase your chances of success, each expert has offered some guidance and advice on how to do your job. Project managers, this is for you.
My advice to the project managers is, first, remember, you're not just barking orders. You have your job to do, and when your job is done, your job is then to help the team.
Tool engineers, this is for you.
When you're designing a tool, it's important to prototype it and test it. And in that first test, you're going to find out things you didn't realize. Things are going to go wrong. Things are going to break. And so you're going to have to continuously revise that design until you reach the final design that's going to do everything you want it to.
Human factors engineers, this is for you.
The advice I have for students is, make sure that you've got every hand size testing every single tool that you make.
And geologists, this is for you.
As a geologist, you want to make sure you pick the sample that you want to get and use the right tool for the jobs.
As a project manager,
as a tools engineer,
as a human factors engineer,
as a geologist, I wish you the best of luck on your mission.
You got this.
Please check in with your mission director to ensure all safety guidelines are followed and to determine what group sharing will happen at the end of the activity. Good luck. You've got this.